Hey everyone, Kevin here. Today, I want to show you how you can set up an email signature in Microsoft Outlook. We're going to start with the basics. I'll show you how you can set up a simple text-based signature first. Then we're going to spice things up a little bit. I'll show you how you can include a handwritten signature within your signature. I'll show you how you can add a logo, maybe a photo of yourself, and I'll even show you how you can include social media links as part of your signature. But maybe you're lacking creativity today. I'll also show you how you can access a massive catalog of signature templates. You could go through there, you could pick and choose your favorite, and you'll have an amazing looking signature. All right, let's jump on the PC and let's create a signature. To create a new email signature, open up Microsoft Outlook. Once you have Outlook open, click into the Home tab within the Mail view. And once you're there, click into a new email message. You can also press Control N, and that'll also open up a new message. This opens up a new email message. And as you can tell, I don't yet have a signature. My message is just completely blank. To create a signature, click on the Message tab up on top, and right here in the center, there's an option for Signature. Click on this. Right here, you can also see that I don't yet have any existing signatures, but down below, I can click on Signatures to create a new one. Let's click on this. This now opens up a prompt where I can create my signature. Right up here at the top, I can select the email account that I want to associate this signature with. I'm going to select this account right here. Next, I can select the signature that I want to edit. Now, I don't yet have a signature, so I'll go over on the right-hand side and click on New. This opens up a prompt where I can type in a name for my signature. Now, the most fitting name for this signature is Amazing Signature because this is going to be an amazing signature. Once you're done typing in a name, click on OK. Here now, I can see the name for my new signature, and down below, I can edit and create my new signature. I'll go in and type in some text for my signature. I've now added a very basic signature. I have my name, my title here at the Kevin Cookie Company, and I also get to promote the company website. See, I always tell leadership that these tutorial videos are worthwhile doing. I get to promote our company to thousands and thousands of people. Right up here, you can edit your signature. You could select the font, the size, bold, italicized, underline. Here you could select colors. You can also set the alignment for your signature. So you can go crazy with these different settings to format your signature how you want it to look. Now that I've gone through and I've made all of my edits, I can come down here to save my new signature. So right here, if I want to come back and edit this signature again, I've now saved it and I can come back at any time to make additional changes to this. We're almost ready to start using this new signature, but we do have a few more decisions that we need to make. Down at the very bottom, I can decide when I want to include this signature. Right here, I can include it with new messages. Currently, it's set to none, so when I create a new email, this signature won't be included. Now, I want to show the world this new signature, so I'll select my amazing new signature, so this will be included with any new message. Also, I can decide whether I want to include my signature for replies and forwards. So here too, I could choose none or I could select my signature. Now, what's really interesting is you can choose different signatures for new messages or replies and forwards. So maybe a new message will have my more comprehensive signature, and then maybe replies and forwards has a slimmed down signature. Especially if I have an email thread where I'm going back and forth, I probably don't need my full signature showing up again and again. For now, just for simplicity, I'll choose none. Next, let's click on OK. I'm now back in my email message, but I don't yet see anything. Well, that's because we need to open up a new message. I'll close this one out, and now this is the moment of truth to see if this worked. Let's click on new email. And look at that, there is my beautiful new email signature included in this new message. Now, I mentioned earlier that this signature is now associated with this email account. Here, if I change the email account that I send from, here you'll see that the signature is not associated with this email address. So this is just one thing to call out. Your signature will only show up with the defined email account. Now, let's say that here I have a new email message, and maybe I set my signature to none for both new messages and also replies and forwards. I can still insert my signature whenever I want. here within this blank new message, here again, I can go up to signature and here I'll click on this dropdown and here I can select whatever signature I want to include. So let's say I had multiple signatures, I can choose from those multiple signatures. Now I just have one, so let's select amazing signature and there it is. There's my signature and I just inserted it into this message. So far, we've just been looking at the basics of including a signature in an email message. But in the intro, I said we're also gonna look at how to spice things up so you truly have an amazing signature. And I don't know about you, but when I look at this signature right now, it's not truly amazing. So it's not really living up to the name. Once again, let's go up to signature right here, and then let's click into signatures. This once again opens up the prompt where I can either create or edit a signature. And here I see the signature that I just created. So when I click on this, I can now edit it. And right down here, I see my signature. Now first, I think it'd make it a lot more interesting if I included a handwritten signature. Here I'll enter down to give me a little bit of space. And over here on the far right hand side, there's the option to insert a picture. Let's click on that. This opens up my Windows file picker, and right here on my desktop, I've included my signature. I'll select this file and then click on insert. And look at that, I have now included my signature within my signature. This is starting to remind me of the movie Inception. If you're interested in how to create an electronic signature like this, I've included a link in the description to a video that'll walk you through step by step how you can create something that looks like this. Next, I also want to include a photo of myself alongside my signature. Unfortunately, we can't do all of that within this view here, so for now I'm going to click on OK and I'll build out my signature right here. First, I want to get the most recent version of my signature that includes my handwritten name. I'll go up here to signature and let me click on amazing signature and now here you can see the most recent copy. Next, I'm going to insert a table. I want to have a photo to the left of my signature here. Right up here, I'll go up to insert on the top tabs, and right here, there's the option to insert a table. Now, I'm going to insert a table with two columns and one row. Let's click on this. My table is now included in the email message, and I'll copy all of my signature content here, and I'll press Ctrl X to cut it. Right over here now, I'll press Ctrl V to paste it in. Next, I want to include a photo of myself. Now, you can include any type of photo. This could be a photo of yourself. It could also be your company's logo, whatever you want to include. To include the photo, I'll go up to insert over here, and then there's the option to insert a picture. I'm going to select a picture from my device. This once again opens up the Windows file picker, and look at that, there's a very nice picture of myself. Next, I'll click on insert. This inserts the picture of Cookie Monster. He truly is the lead cookie eater. But the picture is massive right now. I don't think people would really appreciate it or take me seriously if I include a picture that's this big as part of my signature. Here I'm going to resize it down just so it's a more reasonable size as part of my signature. Maybe I'll make it about that big there. Next, I'm going to pull in this divider between these different columns just so it's a little bit closer. Now, my signature's starting to look pretty good, but I have these borders as part of the table. I want to get rid of these. To get rid of the borders, highlight the table, and then right up here on the tabs, there's the option for table design. When you click on that, all the way over on the right-hand side, you can format what the borders look like. And here I'm going to select no border. Look at that, this is starting to look like a pretty amazing signature. The signature looks pretty good, but it's not yet an official signature. Here, let me copy all of these contents that I just created, and here I'll press Ctrl X. It's now on my clipboard. Now, once again, go up to the Message tab up on top, go over to Signature, and let's once again click into Signatures. Here again, I see my amazing signature, and this is where we left off before, but I now want to include this image. Here I'll highlight all of this and let me delete that and now I'll paste in the new version that I made in the email message. What's nice is you can use the email message to format your signature. Within the email message, you have more controls over formatting. You could insert things like tables. You could define what the table looks like. You can more easily insert images. So it's actually a really nice practice to just create your signature within the email and then paste it into this interface. This interface isn't quite as rich and you don't have quite as many tools to make your signature look amazing. This is now looking good, so I'll click on Save, and then let's click on OK. Back within the email message now, let me select my signature and look at that. This looks pretty good. Next, I want to show you how you can also include social media links within your signature and then link off to your profile. To do that, once again, let's go up to signatures and click into signatures. Here in my signature, I probably want to include a YouTube link. I mean, I have a YouTube channel where I do these tutorials, so I might as well promote it as part of my signature. Here I'll enter down, and right over here, once again, I have the option to insert an image. I'll click on this. This once again opens up the Windows file picker, and here I see the icon for YouTube. I'm going to select this one. You might be wondering, well, where do I get these different icons from? You could go onto Google, you could go onto Bing, and you can search for Twitter, LinkedIn, Facebook icons, and you'll find them there. You can then save them and incorporate it into your signature. I'm going to select this one for YouTube, and then I'll click on Insert. This has now inserted the YouTube icon into my signature, but it doesn't actually do anything yet. I can't click on it. I'll select the image here, and over on the far right hand side, there's the option to insert a hyperlink. Let's click on this. This opens up the insert hyperlink prompt, and now I can type in an address. I'll type in my name, kevinstratvert.com. I've set that up so it redirects to my YouTube page. This all looks good, so I'll click on OK. I now have my social media link working just like I expect it to. And before we click on OK and test this out, I do want to show one more thing that we have here on this page. And it's the option to insert a business card. Now that sounds interesting. What does that do? Well, let's click into it to find out. This opens up a prompt where I can select different contacts from my different email accounts. You could go through, you could choose one of your contacts, and then it'll take all of their contact details and incorporate it into what's called a business card. So here you see the business card with one of my buddies, Tom Maverick Cruz. When I click on OK, it simply inserts an image with all of those contact details. You might be thinking, well, is there anything special about being a business card? Not really. It simply takes all of the details and turns it into an image. And actually, I don't like it quite as much because you can't make these different elements clickable. Instead, when you build the signature just on your own, you can have a URL. You could have different icons that are clickable. With a business card, you can't do that. If you like this format, well, then you're pretty much done. But if you want a little bit more control, and personally, I think if you want your signature to look a little bit better, I'd probably just make it on your own and don't use a business card. For now, I'll simply delete this business card. Okay, I'm ready to test this out now, so I'll click on OK. Once again, to make sure that it uses the latest signature, I'm gonna go up here, click on Signature, and then Amazing Signature. And here now you see the YouTube logo is here. When I hover over, you see that it includes the URL. So if I were to click on this now, it would take me to my YouTube page. All in all, I think this signature looks pretty good. Now, maybe you tried following all of these steps and maybe your signature doesn't yet hit that bar of amazing. Next, I want to show you how you can access a catalog of many different signatures and you could just pick and choose and use that. Once again, just like we've been doing all along, click on Signature up above and click into Signatures. Within the Signature dialog, once again, there's a link down here that says Get Signature Templates. Let's click on this. This opens up a support.microsoft.com website, and right here there's a link once again to Get Template. Let's click on this. And once again, there's another page now where we can download the template. Next, let's click on Download. And this is now downloaded a Word document. Let's click into this. This opens up a Word document with many different templates that I can choose from. So I could take any one of these and I could use it for myself. Here I could go in and I could edit the phone number, I could edit the website. So I could pretty much take this as is. To use one of these signatures, hover over one of them and you'll see this icon appear. Click on that and that'll select the entire signature. Next, click on Control C to copy. Back within Outlook, I now want to use this new template. I'll click on New and let me type in template as the name. Next, I'll click on OK. Right here now, I could come down and I could paste in my new signature. And look at that, this looks pretty good. I'll probably want to go through and edit some of these details and edit the website. And look, I even have my social media links down at the bottom. I could link these to my profile. And right here with the picture, I could swap this out or I could just leave it in place. We've all been working from home for so long. Who actually knows what other people look like anymore? For all you know, I might look just like Lorenzo. Once I'm all done, I'll go down and click on Save, and then I could decide when I want to use this new signature. All right, well, hopefully you now have an amazing looking email signature. If you do, please give this video a thumbs up. To see more videos like this in the future, please consider subscribing. Also, if you want to see me cover any other topics in the future, leave a note down below. All right, well, that's all I had for you today. I hope you enjoyed, and as always, I hope to see you next time. Bye.